This is Tamara at mooglyblog.com, and in this video, I'm going to demonstrate how to work round 7 of the Moroccan basket pattern. Now, there are tutorials for the basic stitch pattern in this basket and other parts of this pattern on mooglyblog.com already, but round 7 of the outer portion is a little bit different, so that's the part I'm going to demonstrate today. I will be using the yarn that I used in the pattern, Heartland Thick and Quick, as well as a Furls K hook. And you can see I've got the outer portion already started, rounds 1 through 6. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6 are already made, so we're ready for round 7. But first, let's take a quick look at the finished project. Here I have the basket, and I know the camera's a little close right now, but I wanted to make sure we'd be able to see the details. This right here is round 7. Now this part, the Moroccan tile stitch in the round, is already linked with a tutorial in the written pattern. But it's this round 7 that I know is giving people a little bit of trouble, so that's what I'm going to demonstrate right now. Let me set this aside here, as well as our whole skein, and I'll go ahead and get started. Now, to begin round 7, I'm going to start with a chain 2, 1, 2, and this is going to count as the first half of our first double crochet 2 together. So this particular stitch is a little bit different than the rest of the round. From here, I'm going to yarn over, and then I'm going to double crochet in the next stitch, right there. Under both loops, of course. And that right there will count as our first double crochet 2 together. Then I'll chain 1, and then I'll make our next double crochet 2 together. This is, I think, the part that confuses people a little bit. You can think of a double crochet 2 together as having two legs, those two double crochets that then come together at the top. So for the first leg, the first half, we're going to go into the same stitch that we finished the previous stitch in, so right there. So I yarn over, I go right into that same stitch, pull up my loop, there we go, yarn over, pull through 2, and with 2 loops remaining on the hook, I will yarn over, go into the next stitch, which hasn't had a stitch in it yet, yarn over, pull through 2, and then with our 2 loops left on the hook, I'll pull up a little bit more yarn, I will finish the double crochet 2 together. So you can see this starts off the stitch pattern, which is normally pretty open because we're working other colors into it, but here at the bottom we want it to be a little more solid. So let's continue. Now I am going to pull up a little bit more yarn here. This thick yarn does go quickly. So I'll yarn over. Then I'm going to go to the next stitch, right here. With 2 loops remaining on the hook, I'll go to the next stitch and make and yarn over with 3 loops left on the hook for double crochet 2 together. Then I'll yarn 1. And then I'm going to do a double crochet 2 together that shares that stitch right there. So you can think of this as sort of like making a V stitch, but I'm filling in any holes that might naturally get left. So I've got a double crochet 2 together in 2 stitches, then I chain 1, then I make another double crochet 2 together where the first leg shares space with the last leg of the one previous. Then I go to the next 2 stitches, make a double crochet 2 together, chain 1, then make another double crochet 2 together, and the first and last again go into that same stitch. So let's do it one more time. This is our basic repeat for this round. We go into the next stitch, start a double crochet, stop with 2 loops left on the hook, yarn over, go into the next stitch, start our double crochet, then with 3 loops left on the hook, we yarn over and pull through all 3. Then we chain 1. Then we make our next double crochet 2 together, putting the first leg in the same stitch as the second leg of the previous one, like so. Then yarn over and go to the next stitch. So each one of these repeats is actually only worked over 3 stitches of the previous round. We've got a double crochet 2 together over the first 2 stitches, then a chain 1, then a double crochet 2 together over the last 2 stitches. That center stitch is shared. So that is the basic stitch pattern for round 7. Be sure to rewind and watch it again if you need a little bit more help. We just continue that all the way around and join right to the top of that first double crochet there. That's the top of our first double crochet two together. After that, you can follow the Moroccan tile stitch in the round tutorial, and be sure to check out the written pattern for the basket on mooglyblog.com. Thanks so much for watching, and if you enjoy what you've seen, please be sure to subscribe to our channel.